Brett, the PlayStation VR is here. You reviewed it.
I did, yeah.
What do you make of it?
I absolutely love it. I think it's brilliant, yeah.
So you've played pretty much all the games that come with it?
Yeah, well, as much as time permits, yeah. We got sent a bunch of games to play, and I've been trying to get through as many of them as I can.
What games should I play? Can I get a top five from you?
Yeah, so the first one I'd recommend, especially if you're a Batman fan, would be the Batman Arkham VR. It's a short experience. You'll get through it in about 90 minutes, I'd say, but it's only £15 on the PlayStation Store. And it's really, really good. And it's a nice way to introduce you to VR itself as well, if you haven't played any games. That you don't have to move around much. The only way you move is by, you stand still, you look around as either Bruce or Batman, and you can zip from point to point. And it's like a murder mystery case. So the second one, you'd need the move controllers, which again, you'd have to buy separately along with the camera and stuff. But I've played it and it's absolutely terrifying, but it's Until Dawn, Rush of Blood.
Welcome, my friend, and step right up to the ride of your life.
The reason why I recommend this one is because it's a really good example of what a shooting game can be in VR. So it goes a bit towards the cheap scares a bit too often for me, but the reason, again, why I put it in here is because I just want a Time Crisis VR game. This is a really good indication.
We all do.
Exactly. And when you've got the two move controls and you're just sat there and you're just picking things off and you're shooting around, it is a lot of fun when it's in that full flow. And it's a roller coaster. So you're just sat still and the game takes you on the journey.
But can you put your gun sideways?
You can. Yeah, you can. Yeah, yeah. And even the bullets will fly out the side as well. Yeah, it's really good fun for
that's
that.
That's awesome.
Well. Yeah, it's really good.
So what's your number three?
So number three, I've gone with Drive Club. This is another one where you'll already be familiar with the way the game plays, a typical driving game, but when you're sat in the cockpit view, I can look at my wing mirror, I can look at the rear view mirror, I can just look to my left and to my right and see if there's any cars around before I take turns. And I think it's really nice. It flows really nice, it's really smooth to play. You may feel a bit motion sick if you get into a crash or you spin the car. Also, I really don't recommend you come out of cockpit view, which is something you can do in the game. And you can have a camera where the car is just in front of you.
Okay.
I wouldn't do
that. So first person's better.
Yeah, yeah. It's the more immersive and it's definitely the more comfortable that I've found to play. You can play it with steering wheel if you have set up. And I did that at a demo and that was incredible. The funny thing was, because I had the VR headset on, I just had to sit there like that and they had to bring the pedals to my feet and I had to do that until they give me the controller. But yeah.
Are you saying you're not the tallest?
No, exactly.
I have had to lower this chair a little bit. But
yeah, that's true. Yeah, we've done that classic thing of the interview, you just have to crouch.
You're doing a Tom Cruise, you're doing it very
Tom
well.
Tom Cruise, yeah, yeah, perspective. These cameras are all set up for perspective, that's what it's done.
So, your top two, give me your number two.
So
PSVR game.
Yeah, the next one is, this will be one that's definitely more intense in terms of a VR experience, but it's really, really good to play. It's Eve Valkyrie, which is a space arcade dogfire, and it's a very intense game, it's multiplayer. The good thing is you can play with PC players as well, it's cross-platform. And it's a really, really solid multiplayer shooter. Once you can, again, now that PSVR is out, I'm hoping that the servers will populate a bit more with more players, but even when I was playing against AI, you can get some really intense dogfights going on. You will be barrel rolling, you will be flipping, so...
Bit of motion sickness?
You see, you can get that, but the way I've compensated for it, and this might help you guys at home as well, is whenever you're turning, I tilt my head which way I'm going.
Oh, cool.
And that's helped me get over the initial motion sickness, and with that, that's alleviated it a lot.
So what's your number one favorite PlayStation VR game?
Yeah, see, this was a really, really tough one because it's a game within a game. So that's really stupid to say, sort of.
I'll let you off.
Yeah, I'll explain. So it's in PlayStation VR Worlds, which is a 5-game minigame collection made by a London studio. And the game I pick is the London Heist. Now,
I've seen a lot of trailers for this.
Yeah, you start, it's another shooter, and this one felt a lot more like what I would envision Time Crisis to be. It's like the getaway meets Time Crisis, and
So it's on rails.
Yeah, yes, and it was a very nice introduction again to PlayStation VR, nice. And it's so much fun. That's the most fun I've had in VR right now in PlayStation VR as well. Reload your Muppet! PlayStation VR is lacking that single standout system seller at the minute.
But it has just come out.
Exactly, and it's got a lot of good introductions to VR. Like I say, it breaks you in quite well with the likes of Batman, with Drive Club, and with PlayStation VR Worlds, and even with Eve, even though that is much more intense in terms of the experience. I think there's a lot of options out there for people to know what they're looking for as well.
Awesome, thank you very much, Brett. And for more on the PlayStation VR, stay tuned to trustedreviews.com.